Hi guys, welcome to another video, and in this video we will learn how to set up Facebook pixel, or you can say meta pixel, to your Shopify store. Now let's first understand what is meta pixel and why do we need to connect it with our Shopify store. Why do we need to add it? The reason is that because when you create a store, obviously it's not gonna get sales automatically. You'll have to present your store to potential buyers, and you're gonna do that with the Facebook ads or Google ads. And if you are doing that with the Facebook ads, then Facebook requires you to connect Facebook pixel so it can track all of the visitor behavior and try to get you more sales by understanding the data which is it's getting from your store. So for example, I'm a potential buyer and I come to your store and I visit a couple of pages and then click on add to cart and then purchase one of the product. Facebook pixel or meta pixel will track all of that stuff, and it will then enhance the performance of your Facebook ad by analyzing the data through their AI algorithms and their algorithms. So that's why we are connecting Facebook pixel to our Shopify store. And in this video, I'm going to show you a simple way on how you can do that. Very beginner friendly. Anyone can do that. Whoever is a basic tech savvy, who have basic knowledge, right? So let's get into the screen where I'll show you guys how you can connect Facebook pixel to your store. So that's our development store, guys. And here we will go to the backend. And from there, click on search and then click on apps. And from there, click on all recommended apps. And here you can simply go to Shopify App Store. So click on Shopify App Store. And here we will search for Facebook and Instagram. And our app will be showing up. But in my case, this app is showing up here. It might not be visible to you. So you'll have to add in Facebook and Instagram on the search. And you'll have to install this app. This is a Shopify app, which is an official app from Meta. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to click here and then install that app. So click on install. And here's the screen which you will get, where it's asking you to allow the access for customer and store owner. And that's all of the data which this app will be accessing to connect it with the Meta ads or Facebook ads. Okay, now click on install. Now, once you install the app, you will have a screen like this. And I'm going to click on get started. From this screen, click on connect account, which will connect your Facebook account with this app, and it will also create a new pixel, and you will also have the option to choose pixel. Now, before clicking on connect account, make sure you are logged in and make sure you have Meta Business Suite or Facebook Business Suite. I'm already logged into my Facebook Business Suite. So all you have to do is just after logging into Facebook, go to business.facebook.com. And you have a screen like this, right? So that's the main screen of the Facebook Business Suite. And I have multiple businesses on this Meta Business Suite because we also manage Facebook ads for some of our clients. And if you scroll down and you see data sources, in data sources, you have pixels and data sets. Now, when you click on pixels, it will show you that all pixel IDs have a new location. So now pixel has been renamed to dataset. Previously it was called pixels and now it is dataset. So you have to click on datasets where you will see all of your pixels, aka datasets, right? And now let's get back to our app of the Shopify and then click on connect account. And from here, I'm going to click on continue to connect my Facebook account. Click on continue as Bilal. Okay, now my Facebook account is connected. Now you can see I have multiple businesses showing up. So I'm going to click on the one which I need to connect it with. Now on this screen, we are sharing data with this app and connecting with Facebook Pixel and choosing our preference. And we have three options of preferences where we have conservative, enhanced, and maximum. So let's check out the conservative, what data which we are sharing when we choose this conservative preference. So click on that. And when I scroll down, I have this detail showing up where it's telling me that you'll be sharing page and product views, items added from cart, search terms, customer click ID, agent ID, payment information, and when someone initiated the checkout or purchase. And on enhanced, we have some additional data which we'll be getting, which is customer name, email address, meaning we are sharing our store data with the meta pixel, with the meta data set to enhance the conversion and to analyze the data and give us more sales. And in maximum, we have additional where we have number and address, phone number and address as well. We'll be sharing our customer phone number and address as well. I'm going to choose the enhanced, which is the recommended from MetaPixel. So let's click on save. And now here we have multiple pixels showing up, which are from my Facebook business. So these are my data sets, and all of these data sets are showing up here. And I'm going to click on create new. I'm assuming you do not have any data set created. So let's click on create new, and it will automatically create the new data set. So you can see that it created this WebSensePro pixel, which will be created after the submission. So let's click on confirm and agree to the terms and conditions. Now let's click on submit for review. And now it's finalizing the channel setup. While it's finalizing, guys, I wanna tell you guys that if you are new to Shopify and if you want to create a new store for just $1 a month, there's a link in the description. If you use that link, you'll be getting your store in just $1 a month with 3 days free trial. So make sure to check out that link. Also, if you are new to this channel, I have created multiple other tutorials to help you guys, to help you with your store, enhancing the layout, adding additional features which are not available anywhere else for free. So if I go to this development store, you can see that I have this cool looking transparent header where if I hover over, it changes the color. Also, I have this cool looking mega menu with animated images and this video on autoplay loop. It's continuously looping the video. All of these features are not available by default. You'll have to add additional settings. And all of these tutorials are available for free in this channel. So make sure to subscribe the channel and check out all other tutorials as well. Okay, now let's continue with our pixel. And now the finalization has been completed. Now let's test our Facebook pixel, that if it's tracking all of the data. Let's go back to our Facebook business. And here I'm going to click on any of the data set, which is also pixel. Click on these three small dots and then click on open in events manager, where we will find our newly created Facebook pixel. So that's our event manager where we will find the latest pixel which we created. So that's the latest one which is created. And here let's click on test events and test the events. Before testing the events, make sure to match the pixel ID. If you click on settings, you have this pixel ID showing up. You can see that it's also showing up the date which is being created, which is the day of the video as I'm recording. So make sure to match this pixel ID by going to this app, the Shopify app, the Facebook, Instagram, and click on settings. And then this is the ID. Make sure you test the same event which is being created by the Shopify app and connected with this app. Okay, now let's click on test events to see if it's properly working. Now let's click on test events. And here I'm going to test browser events. So I'm going to copy over my online store URL. So that's my development store. I'm going to copy the URL and paste it on test events. And it's already started. You can see that it shows that someone viewed the page. So if I click on clear activity, you can add your URL here and then click on open website where it will track all of the data. You can see it's now tracking the page view. Now let's try adding product to the cart to make sure that if it's working fine. So that's my product. I'm going to click on add to cart and then go to the cart page. Now let's go back to our events manager. And you can see that it's tracking that someone added product to the cart. And if I go over the event details, you can see all of the parameters here, that what's the product title and what's the currency and what's the value. So it's passing all of the data layer variables to the Facebook data set or Facebook pixel, right? Now let's click on proceed to checkout. And I'm going to add a test order here to make sure our purchase has been tracked. So let's add in some test details. Test order. Click on pay now. Okay, we just placed a test order. Now let's check out our Facebook pixel to see if it's tracking. Now you can see that it's tracking all of the data. You can see that it shows first add to cart, then initiated the checkout, and it's also showing that what we added in the checkout. And then we added the payment info and the purchase event. So here's our order value, which has been tracked completely, and that's the event ID. Cool, right? So that's it for the video, guys. In this video, we learned in detail and in a very easy way on how to install Facebook Pixel and testing that Facebook Pixel, that if it's working properly. If you like the video, let me know in the comment below and let me know what more you would like to learn. Until next video, have a great day.